Thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to cover how to make a coordinate system. So every part in SOLIDWORKS have a coordinate system and a by default origin. Notice down here there is a tridec, and you can see we have x, y and z directions. And if we are gonna go into the origin, so we have a origin in the center of our body. So if we want to go and if we want to change the coordinate system, so we can change and we can have our own coordinate system. So it's very useful when you want to figure it out the mass of inertia, or if you want to weigh, or if you want to working with a CNC machine. So what you can do is by using such coordinate system you can make your offset wherever you want to define. Okay, let's go into the evaluate and let's go into the mass properties first. And you can see like report coordinate values relative to default, because we have only one default coordinate system. So by using that default coordinate system, it's gonna explain the mass and moment of inertia and center of mass and everything, because we have only one coordinate system. So if we have multiple coordinate system, what we can do is we can just select whatever the coordinate system we want to use, and then we would see all these values are gonna change. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SOLIDWORKS learner, then I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would found a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you.
Okay, what we can do is if we want to create our own coordinate system, we can go into the features and then we can go into the reference geometry, and you can see there is a third option which is coordinate system. Okay, for that what I need to do is I just need to select a point. Suppose I want to make a coordinate system, suppose here. So our coordinate system is gonna move here, and then if I want to have a x direction, suppose I want to have a x direction into this end, and then y is on the top and z is outside, so it's fine. Still you can change if you want, and you can just select x, y and z, and you can give whatever the direction you want to give. So in this way we can create our own coordinate system. Look, this is coordinate system. And another thing, like if I want to made a multiple coordinate system, suppose I want to select this face and I'm gonna go into the sketch, and suppose I want to create a line. I'm gonna go and I'm gonna create a line from here to here, and then again I'm gonna create a second line. What I can do is I can go into the features and into the reference geometry and coordinate system, and I can select this point. So our coordinate system is gonna move here, and I want to have x in this direction and then y and z. I can select y in this direction and then z is outside. So in this way I have a second coordinate system as well. Let's go into evaluate again, and let's go into the mass properties. So as you can see, now we have multiple coordinate system, so we can change if we want to have the values by using coordinate system 1 or coordinate system 2. So let's say coordinate system 1. So you can see the center of mass and moment of inertia, all those values are gonna change. Okay, there is one more thing, like we can just change the names of these coordinate system. We would just go here in the feature menu and we just need to click on them, and then we can change the name whatever we want, but it's up to you. Okay, there is one more thing, we can change the names of these coordinate system by clicking them, and in this way we can change the name, and it's up to you whatever the name you want, or you can just leave it. Okay, so in this way, like if we have multiple coordinate systems, so what we can do is when we are going to CNC lab, so what we can explain to them, like this is our offset number 1 and this is our offset number 2, and in this way we can have whatever we want. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SOLIDWORKS learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.
Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SOLIDWORKS learner, then I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would find a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you.